Hi, good evening to all. I am Sudha, Department of Commerce CA. Today we are discuss about communication. First, what is communication? Communication is nothing but communication is simply the act of transfer information from one place to another. The next one is the process of sending and receiving through verbal and non-verbal means oral communication. Writing, it means written communication. For oral communication means speaking communication. Next, the written communication is one of the non-verbal communication. That means the some papers, articles, journals, this type of communication for written communication. Next, the communication comes from the Latin word communicare, which means to share the information others. Next, first of all this is what we can understand the communication. First, what we can talk and by what we understand the knowledge. Next, listen, what we can understand. Involve it means consisting interest of the engaging. Change it means the action, some action. This is the process of communication. This is sender, that is receiver. Sender gives a message to the receiver. The receiver replies the feedback of sender. Next, this is the communication process. This is the sender. This is the receiver. This is microphone. This is the transmission control of communication process. The sender sends the message to receiver. The receiver what we can understand the message to reply from the sender. Here the transmission control is the process of transmission are here available. Next, the elements of communication. There are three types of elements. First one is sender, next one is receiver, third one is communication channel. First of all, sender. First, what is sender? The person or persons responsible for a creating a message to be sent, typically understood as a sender in a communication process. It simply says easy to understand the communication. For example, the politician giving speech via day to day to see the political speech. The next, parent lecturing a child. The next one is all of them are people sending messages. Next, receiver to receive the message from sender. The person or person who are receiving the created message are refer to a receivers in a communication process. For example, an audience receive the politician speech. The next one is the unfortunate child is the recipient of the parents lecture. Next, the communication channel for the to communicate the transfer the information from sender to the receiver. It is the main characteristics of our elements of communication. The medium through which a sender or a receiver uses to send his or her messages is termed as a communication channel. The channel may be verbal or non-verbal communication, any other form of languages. Doesn't matter. For example, speech is a channel, writing is a channel, non-verbal gestures are channels, voice tones are channels. Next, encoding is nothing but to send the message to receiver. The receiver accept the message from and they reply the feedback of sender. That is the encoding. When a sender attempts to replicate his or her internal thoughts or feelings into some kind of external message or medium for the sake of transmitting those thoughts or feelings to another person or persons, the whole process can be called as encoding. Next, decoding. Decoding is nothing but message decoding occurs when the receiver attempts to ascertain the meaning of sender's message. And figuring out what other people mean is not easy. I'm sure all of us at times when we are had others become frustrated us because we don't understand what they running. Noise means sound. It is any force that interferes with effective communication is called noise. For example, external noise. The external noise refers to the physical phenomenon that might impair receiver ability to decode a message. For the examples of elevator, music, blaring, treadmills, running. This is the communication skills, basic skills. The follows up. First one is express own reflections and ideas clearly. The next one is develop relationship. And the next one is provide feedback from receiver to open others' feedback. For example, accept other answers without prejudices, references, and etc. The next one is respect attitudes and opinions of others. And last one, finally, to tolerate different customs and cultures. And the next one is present your ideas so that others are receptive to your point of view. And the next is value of teamwork. The teamwork is very important for the our communication. And know how to build a cooperation and commitment. Strive to understand other people and to be empathetic. Be able to work with people you have difficulties with becoming negative. Four key points of communication. Very simple steps are following. If you want to convince others with a message, convince that you are a good. The next one is use words that your audience easily understand. The audience are easy to understand. The next one is speak direct. It is a conversational way for a better communication. The fourth one is move away from egocentrism. The most important effective communication is to follow the question who, what, when, why. First of all, who are communicating. Who are communicating. Next, what you are communicating. Next, why the goal of your communication. And next, when you communicate the issue. Next, how will you communicate the issues. First, the communication is classified into two ways. First one is one-way communication. The next one is two-way communication. One-way communication is nothing but here available only one sender and receiver only participated. Next, the two-way communication is the sender or more than receivers are available. Color communicate meaning. This is nothing but how to change our mindset in the presentation. This is very easy to. This colors are follows. The affects your mood. Yellow color is the warm, exciting, happy. Blue color the reference is the deep, peaceful, supernatural. The green color is defines peace, stillness, nature. And the white color harmony, silence, cleanliness. Black color grief, dark, unknown. And red color means glowing, confidence, alive. Orange color means radiant,